make the streams louder.
Alright, so it's Monday again. Today I got my little Earls and fitting. This is 5/16 to, I believe, 6. Holy shit, this actually might be the wrong damn. Son of a bitch! Might be the wrong size, I'm not sure. But, hold on, let me see. Let me see. Get up in the goodie box right here. Double check. Okay, yeah, it looked kind of big. Looking at it, I was like, oh shit. But yeah, I ordered the right one, so that's good. So basically what this is a compression fitting. This is a factory fuel line right here. I just got this little tubing cutter, you know, for like brass pipes and stuff like that. You basically run it around so you get a real nice cut around it, so you're not pinching it or anything like that, or cutting it because it's got fuel. And then I got a little 180 grit sandpaper to do that. So basically what happens is you put this end on the tube, you put this little guy on there, and then it has a taper to it, and then so when you squeeze them both together, you know, on here, this won't go on because it's all bent and I squeezed it and shit to cut it out of the car, but yeah, basically it'll squeeze that little brass fitting, little brass guy right there, and just smash it on itself. So I'm gonna get up underneath the car right now, cut that, and I got a battery cable today, just from the dirty old Walmart. So I got that mount, or I got the ground cable from Walmart. So got that mounted, and basically after I do that, after you get the slipped right there. After I do that, I got me some oil today. O'Reilly's had like a special on this stuff. So I've heard some pretty good reviews on this Castrol Edge full synthetic titanium shit. 530 for now. You know, I kind of wanted to go with like the 540 stuff, but it was like $10 a quart. And this was like 30 bucks for these, but it came with like a free filter, and you could upgrade to a K&N filter for like $4 extra. So I did that. But Walmart has these for like 26 bucks a piece. But I wanted to, probably the next time I change, I'll probably do the 540, but we'll see. Alright, so now what I'm doing is getting ready to build the AN lines or whatever. And what I mean by that is basically you have to put these lines together, you end up having something like this. And when you cut it, see how it frays all shitty like that? Essentially, it's kind of the same idea, the compression fitting. You guys have never messed with one of these. But so you get the 6AN line, the 6AN things, and then you kind of wiggle that in there, and then that kind of holds it, and then this goes in, and it kind of spreads out all that the rubber and shit in there. It was kind of like a compression deal. But the way I found to cut these, or the way you cut them, is you get a dirty old angle grinder, and then you put some tape on there really, really tight, and go really, really slow when you're cutting through it. And that kind of keeps the ends of these things, instead of fraying out all crazy like that, kind of like this one. Because then you're sitting there trying to fight the braids, you know, trying to put it on like this side. You can see how shitty that is. You know, I mean, you pretty much have to cut that and start over before you can even start on it. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and cut this off real quick. Like I said, just try to go real slow and keep it straight. So yeah, that's pretty much where I need it. So I'm gonna go ahead and yank off my melted tape now. First off, I'm gonna blow through this. Try to get some of that. Try to get some of that crud from out inside of there, because it's not good. So yeah, now basically, just kind of jam. Gonna pick the end that has the shittier phrase on it, so you could smash it in there. Sometimes you could leave the tape on too. That works out sometimes as well. So yeah, that's going in now. And then once it's basically all the way as far as it'll get, pinch it in the vise. And they have like a special thing for these too, where you don't have to pinch it in the vise. Well, it's a thing that you pinch in the vise, and it kind of gives it equal pressure on all corners, and it doesn't make them all, you know, put some divots in your pretty expensive ass fittings. But I don't really care a whole lot about that. Kind of put a little bit of pressure on the bottom. Grab your try not to go below that so it doesn't scratch the thing like it already has from a previous install. But and just basically turn it in. And yeah, there we go. Now we have the fitting for this guy. But so go ahead and throw that back above the tranny tunnel. And I'm gonna go ahead and cut these guys right here, because this is the straightest edge that I could get, so that those fittings will actually slide on there pretty decent. But I know this thing's gonna be a pain in the ass, and it's just gonna be leaking fuel and being dumb, so I'm gonna do that. Alright, well, hopefully you guys are on right now. But I'm gonna go ahead and do the feed, or maybe the return of this guy, because the return one's gonna be, I just know that one's gonna be number one pain in the ass. It's already got it planned for me, I know, because it was just leaking like crazy. But yeah, I kind of picked, see, probably that area. That's a pretty straight shot right there, and I could kind of push that one up and it'll go down. And kind of wanted to go back there, but that doesn't really give me much room to bend these guys down. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get this process started of it just leaking everywhere. Got me a little drain pan. Let me know what you think of last week's video. That was kind of a long one. I'm gonna try to get this close to this end, give me a bunch of room to work with, hopefully. But yeah, let me know what you thought of last week. That long ass video is like 55 minutes or something like that. So you have to let me know what you think of those. I was kind of thinking about breaking it up into two nights, but I'm kind of lazy. Maybe do like a Wednesday one, and you know, something like that. But haven't really decided the week one, you know, especially since I have to drive, you know, way across town to upload. Is actually a hell of a lot easier for me, because then it's basically only work like one night, and then I gotta go drive and upload the next day. I'm just going real slow with this because I know it's gonna start pissing out fuel shortly, which really sucks. I kind of loosened the gas cap too, so I don't know if it was pressurized or, you know, what its deal is, but it definitely has a problem. Yep, there it comes. Yep. There we go. So I think it broke loose. Okay. So yeah, now we're leaking. Stupid thing. But I still gotta sand it. So it's just gonna continue. The leak while I do that is that the sandpaper turns all soggy and shitty. So that's cool too. And this is a pain in the ass. You always think working on cars is cool until you gotta do, yeah, look at that. It's like dissolving the stupid sandpaper. Damn you. I'm leaking down my arm and shit. Come on. Stupid ass. See, this is what I get for not sanding it all the way. Yeah, that sucks ass. That really fucking sucks. I'm not having fun right now. So this is, I don't even know what this is. This is probably 400 wet or dry paper, so hopefully it won't dissolve like that adhesive backed shit. Hey. Man, this is nice to work on when it's not all shit. Alright, so I got the lines all on and shit. I had an issue initially. I don't know if it was just me and my suspicions, but I thought I had it all on wrong or backwards or something like that. But took it off and, you know, switched it around and then, you know, put it back on. But you know, I guess I'm kind of stupid. I don't think there's ever a time I've ever, you know, put fuel lines on a Jay-Z and it's actually been right. So anyhow, I think I got it on right now, but yeah, there's the little barb or whatever. I got it secured going all the way down, kind of up, and then above there, got them both kind of locked in so they don't wiggle or do anything like that. So yeah, that's pretty much that. So now I already tested it, doesn't leak, and everything should be good to go, so I'm gonna go ahead and change the oil in it. I'm gonna change the oil and then turn the key. So on this Jay-Z here, there used to be this pipe right here that would go basically on top of that whole situation. It goes in the block. I'll show you. Let's see. See right there, there's the oil pressure. Damn it. Okay, oil pressure sender. I'm trying to aim my head. Damn you. Okay. So you can see right there, that's the temp sensor that's going to go for the cooling fans. It's basically going to tell it on and off. And yeah, it almost looks crooked in there, but and then I wired up that. So basically it'll turn the fans on at like 185 and turn them off at like 175, or turn them on at like 195 and off at 185. And I wired up the oil pressure sender. So, all right, so this thing is pretty much just bone dry. So what did I do with that? Where'd it go? Oh, so no oil on it or in it. So I'm gonna go ahead and pour some in there real quick. Some liquid gold in this bastard. It's on there a bit.
So before I started it, well, pretty much before I hooked up those gauges or whatever, because I wanted to hook up the oil pressure one, you know, to see when I first started it. So I figured, you know, I'd go ahead and hook up a few other things. So I got that sensor right there, the temp sensor in the factory hole. Basically, just had a factory block off in it, like a little port. But when I was looking at the coil pack covers, you can see right there, I put a little bit of electrical tape. See that guy right there, down to the bare wires, and it was kind of chafed through, and I was like, oh shit. So the back one looks good, but you know, I guess there's just so much damn heat, it kind of dicks with this stuff pretty good. But yeah, so I just kind of, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a light coat of the electric, or this liquid tape on it real quick. On these, and then I'm going to take a thin piece of electrical tape and kind of squeeze it around it, so it'll hopefully seal it up pretty good. But yeah, that JDM engines. Oh, but the timing belt looks, I mean, holy shit, looks almost new if you you know, look at it. So, and you could see, well, when I was down there on the bottom, you could see it looked like almost like a fresh mark on the front cover. So maybe it maybe recently had a timing belt, I don't know. Okay, so anyhow, first startup, I'm assuming, I hope it starts. If I wired everything correctly, it should start, but first, I'm gonna go ahead and build oil pressure. I have, let's see, we'll move this. Move that guy under there, that's my starter signal wire. So yeah, we'll stick basically everything on there. Let's see, so no fuel. Woo! So that's start. This is the fuel right here. So we'll go ahead and crank it until we see some oil pressure. Fucking idiot. Alright, so I got my safety glasses on and my ear things, and I'm getting ready to cut some shit. But I figured I'd show you something real quick. Oh, so this is the manual transmission fluid I got.
It was like $33 a quart for it. I bugged them a little bit and they put me at a discount. So I got it for like 66 for three quarts. I think the tranny takes like 2.9 or something like that. But yeah, that's some expensive stuff. It's GL4. I was reading some reviews. Some people tried switching over to the Redline, like the MT85 or, you know, that manual transmission fluid that Redline has. And they, I guess it made it feel notchy and shit. So I guess the OEM fluid is the best way to go. So what I'm doing right now is I'm messing with the intercooler piping. Previously, when I cut the intercooler piping, I had the intercooler about an inch forward. So this is, it's close. I mean, it all works. You can kind of see how the bends are a little bit different now. I could probably cut that a little bit and change the angle of it. And I might end up doing that. Probably pull that one back a little bit so it's actually a straight shot. And then right here, kind of a similar situation. But yeah, you could see I could probably cut that back just a tad more and actually get it to go on there a little bit straighter. So I might do that real quick. That's a pain in the ass to cut those because I could basically cut them around with a razor blade to get them straight and stuff. But yeah, I'm thinking I'm going to have to cut probably like a quarter of an inch off of that right there. I don't know. It's not bad. But these fit, you know, they fit in there, but I just don't like I don't have enough, a really clamping area. So I'm basically cutting them like 4.5 inches on there. I went today, the auto parts store, and I got a little 90 degree thing because I couldn't get to that hose down there, which I probably could have, but I was just being lazy and I looped the heater core line. So now I could actually fill the radiator with water. Basically, I'm just going to be doing a distilled water and the red line, the water wetter coolant. So that's what's going to be in the radiator. I don't think I'm going to be driving around when it's freezing out, and it, you know, it's probably going to freeze a couple more times here in Colorado, but it's pretty much going to be in the shop. So what I did over here is I got a piece of intercooler pipe. A lot of times, because I'm cutting it with the angle grinder, when you're cutting it with one of these guys, it's really hard to get it kind of straight around there. You see this right here. Right there's a good example. Basically, you go all the way around and then you get kind of, you know, and it's kind of like those little curly Q up it. So that's kind of what I was trying to do with this, is you get the thick tape and kind of get it straight to kind of do it, and then it's actually pretty straight going around, so just follow the line and then it's at least pretty damn straight. So I'm going to cut these both at 4.5 inches, and this one already has a little bead roll on it, and I'll show you guys a trick here in a minute to do that. I really need to clean up this whole area. I've just been messing with some of the wiring and shit on here. It's kind of in a limp mode, you know, it's where it doesn't want to rev. But once I get the intercooler pipe on, I'm going to go ahead, clean up the shop a little bit around here, all the shit I have laying around, and then make a downpipe. Put the wideband O2 sensor in there and probably get it back most of the way. I might finish it tonight, but yeah, so that's kind of the plan for today. What else? I think that's about it. Just expensive shit is expensive tranny fluid and some cutting. All right, so I got these guys cut. Fuck you. I don't know where my other shit went. Always losing something. So it always goes, okay. All right, so what I'm gonna be showing you real quick is, you know, once you cut, you know, that's kind of the shitty thing about aluminum, but once you cut, that. You get those shitty things on the inside, so you gotta kinda deburr that real quick. Get rid of the little fellas on the inside. And then okay, so that's a lot smoother than it was. See that little bead right there, the little hump to kind of keep the intercooler piping on? Basically what we're trying to do is duplicate that. Here's a set of channel lock crimpers, and you can see it's got kind of that little dimple in there. So what I found to work is you just come right here, other way, where the little pointy thing goes out, and go around it about 1,000 times is what you do. I've showed you guys this before, but there's been a lot of new subscribers and people on there, and they probably don't get too far deep into my random shit. So this is kind of a little trick, and just kind of inch along it. And you can see right now it's kind of coming up with, you know, that one compared to that one. This one's got a little bit of a hump in it now. Just sit here and all day and working out my damn hand, I'm gonna be like fucking Popeye. Once this shit's done, don't fucking shake my hand, I'll break that motherfucker. So yeah, there's pretty much the bead all the way around. It's not even, it's not perfect, but it's definitely better than, you know, not having anything on there at all. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish that. You can tell my shit's crooked. I bucked up okay. But look, I only gotta do that twice. Twice more now. All right, so I got kind of this whole area cleaned up. I put the drive shaft in, got that bolted in except for two bolts, and I kind of ran the car through the gears. Seemed like it felt decent. Well, I put the transmission fluid in there too, so I pumped that in there with that dirty old thing. I mean, it's crazy. I've pumped I don't even know how many gallons of shit into trannies with that thing, in and out and all that stuff. But yeah, so what I'm doing now is I'm gonna do some exhaust. So I went ahead and I cleaned up that little guy right there. Let me throw you on my head real quick. So kind of what I've got so far, I got the welder up and everything too. This extra piece of pipe right here. And so what I'm gonna do, so hopefully you can see that. But yeah, so that's pretty much how it's gonna be. So that sticks down right. I'll go cut that guy, and you know, in the right spots or whatever. But so yeah, that's pretty much how it's gonna be. I think that'll be okay. And I'm just gonna weld that guy right there, and then probably somewhere in here, or probably back here, because I'll use this back section that I'm gonna build for when I do a single turbo later. So I'll probably do the wideband right here, and then I'll leave this V-banded right there onto that, so that way I can just cut off that flange later and use that for the single turbo whenever I do that. But yeah, basically a real similar situation to what I did on the 1J car, is just basically over and out, and then just back out that way. So I gotta grab my box of shit, and I might put you guys on a time lapse, and yeah.
Alright, so we got get everything all welded up. Spritzed a little bit of paint on there. And yeah, this I really don't like the way that looks, but you know, I guess at least it's something. But yeah, I mean when I initially took off the V-bend clamps, these flanges, they have that machined lip right there on the inside, so they actually sit like inside of each other. So as soon as I took off the V-bands, the exhaust actually just stayed up there, you know, kind of stuck in itself with the V-bands and stuff. So that's pretty cool. So I think, do I have to weld this anymore? Yeah, I do. I got to weld. Yep, there we go. Need to weld that. So I gotta weld some more shit. All right, so if you guys have been watching, I've been, well, that's you guys right there. See that? That's you. Anyhow, I got the exhaust pretty much all done. I just gotta pull it down and re-weld a couple of the things on the top where I couldn't get it on here, but it's V-banded right there. V-banded up on the front. It was pretty simple to make. It's probably one of my quicker exhausts. I mean, it doesn't hang too low, so it actually went pretty good. This is the tail section I had when I had, well, basically the whole time I've had this damn car, other than when I cobbled my first shit together a long time ago. But this is what I got when I bought the headers for the LS when I had that in here. And then I've modified it, and I've had about 3 different mufflers on there so far. But I got this like weird ass Flowmaster on there. It's like a dual chamber Chevy shit, you know. So I don't know how that's gonna sound with the JZ. Probably just a straight pipe, but I'll probably pull that off and redo another tail section. But I just kind of wanted to get it, get the exhaust and stuff on it, so I could put some coolant in it and go outside and actually kind of drive it a little bit, you know, just to see how it works, even though it's still in that limp mode. But I want to make sure the tranny and everything shifts good and all that, because that's, I definitely don't want to have any of those issues, and I should be able to figure out that little limp mode type of deal before the end of the deal. But yeah, this is the solid piece right there, so it's pretty much just welded straight up there. I got some decent welds on it. I did a I got a couple of the, you know, I did around the outside, and then I did another like a cover pass as good as I could get it kind of in there. So that's pretty much that. I'm gonna go ahead and yank this shit off and continue with the welding. Well, holy shit. It's I don't know if you guys could tell right there. It's leaking, it's got a drippy dick right now. That back hose coming out, I didn't replace it. I just kind of spliced into it because it was going to be a bitch to get to. It's split, so it's leaking. It's pissing right there on my wiring harness or whatever. But it's pretty much just water with a little bit of water wetter in there right now, so I'm not too worried. I don't have any fans or anything hooked up. Nothing like that. But I am going to take it for a little drive around the complex here, because I tell you what, I'm curious is just shit how this thing is gonna be. Put me some glasses on. All right, yeah, let's see if this son of a bitch moves under its own shit. Try not to dump a bunch of shit everywhere. I mean, I do have shit just fucking everywhere too. All right, fuck, I'm excited for this. I'm really fucking excited for this. Oh, hold on. Thank you.
gonna get a Snapchat of this shit for you guys.
Alright, so I got the little limp ho or the limp limp mode to go away. There's this guy, it's a high performance in Fresno, California. If you want to check out his Facebook page, if you guys ever have like the same issue with yours, he helped me out big time on that, kind of showed me a few little things that he didn't necessarily want me to share. But if you kind of message him, and you know, I'm sure he'd be willing to help you out with the same deal. But yeah, check this shit out. So now it actually like fully revs. So you know what that means? It's time for you to go for a fucking rip. Ah.
Yeah, I just figured it would drag.
Should I let it warm up? Nah. First startup of fucking in the drift car, give her the rape. So I've just been pecking away at some more wiring and shit. I went ahead and I added that little bus thing up there, and then another relay, and the fan relay or whatever. That's the fan switch relay right there. But yeah, essentially everything. I got the headlights, the taillights, all that stuff to work. The blinkers. Let me kind of push this back a little bit. But yeah, so watch. Damn it. Where did they go? So, on here, we got headlights, and we got taillights back there. You could, I think, we should have taillights. And then, so we got taillights, blink, oh, I guess the taillights don't work anymore. I don't know what they did, but... He should be working. But blinker works. Yeah, why the hell did the tail lights stop working? I swore they were just working.
What is this shit? Oh, hold on. Okay. Never mind, I forgot to crimp this guy. I'm sure I didn't arc on a bunch of shit. Okay, so there we go.
We got tail lights, and we got brake lights, which is dope. I basically to wire the brake lights, you just wire a,
positive to one side of that switch, and the other side goes to the thing. For the blinkers, this is that little switch guy I bought, that little off-on deal, and I wired it straight to that blinker thing right there, the little flasher. Gave that power, put power to the center of it. There it is, right down there. But to give power to it, and then, left blinker, right blinker. And so it basically blinks the center no matter what, as long as it has a ground to go to. So yeah, that's that. I got the, the gauge lights come on when you turn the headlights on. And yeah, shit, that's about it. The only other things I guess I really need to do is just plug in the wideband. I was going to run a different wire for the fuel pump. This is the white guy right there. That's what I've been running for a while. So I'm going to go ahead and actually kind of route that a little bit different. Tomorrow I'm going to get some different loom, some like skinnier loom, and actually tie that up all nice and run it back there and kind of get it in the right spots. I was kind of getting low on connectors, and I just kind of wanted to get this thing working. But yeah, it's definitely nice that the tail lights and the brake lights and all that shit just works. So that'll be nice. I also need to wire some power to the power window switches so I could actually roll those things up. But I got the windshield guy coming tomorrow. Right now it is currently Thursday at 5 in the morning. But yeah, I need to wire the fans and a few other little odds and ends and shit like that. Hook up the boost gauge because I don't have that hooked up to anything yet. And yeah, then I think it's early time for a rip. Well, after I get the windshield, I might go for another little quick one tonight just because it runs and shit. Oh, and I need to wire the tachometer too, but that's not a huge deal. Well, that was pretty dope. Doesn't seem like anything's leaking too bad. The power steering just doesn't work. I don't know what's up with that. I'm almost kind of thinking it has to do with that little like sensor dealy thing right there. I don't know if it's a sensor or what it is, or maybe it's just not getting enough fluid actually into it to do anything. Maybe I need to like lift this like bottle up or something, get it bled so it'll actually start circulating through there. But yeah, shit, it seems like it runs pretty good. Sequential turbo mode is kind of weird, or it's kind of like the boost gauge, it kind of like goes up and then it kind of like, and then it like, it's kind of weird because like the first turbo kicks in and then it like waits, lets it spool, and then it kind of like falls down, and then like as it's spooling, and then it's like kind of up top, which is kind of weird. When I initially drove it, this coupler was loose and it was blowing some oil and shit out of there, probably just pissing off the turbos right away, overspinning them trying to keep up with the boost. But yeah, so seemed to run good. Kind of was nice driving it. It seems just like it feels nice. It just feels decently put together, which is definitely a plus. But yeah, so that's about it. I'm gonna go home, take a nap, and then come back and start dicking with this thing again. Probably mount the bumper and the fenders and the windshield, all that shit. I'm gonna go ahead and give it power to the window so I could roll the windows up and down, but the little harness in the back works. So I'm over here just hurting myself dicking with shit. Well, the power steering on here didn't work, and I kind of had an assumption. There's this weird little thing with these two things coming out of it, so I'm assuming what that is kind of like a high low speed like pressure regulator.
to where it would actually like regulate the pressure. So if you're on the highway, it's like kind of firm. If you're in the parking lot, it's probably really powerful, you know, to turn in parking spots and stuff. So I, you know, that extra JZ over there is just coming in handy. Just all the random parts and shit I've been stealing off it. But so I stole, you know, the little center section out of it, and then this little guy, and to connect it to the AN fitting or whatever. And yeah, so it all seems good now. Seems like it's working. I didn't have the brake booster hooked up. And there's this, because I thought this was initially the thing to it, but this doesn't have any vacuum or anything going to it. So I don't know what the hell that does. I think it might have something to do with this, but I don't know. So anyhow, I there's this little kind of bolt deal on the top, so I went ahead and hooked that up to a little AN fitting, this line, and then came over here, and I stole this thing off a Honda, because my other, because my 240 one didn't seem like it was working. Like, I had to go to, like, brake boost or something, or not brake, yeah, brake boost, pretty much, like, left foot braking while you're, like, in boost, and it didn't really work that well, but, so yeah, it's coming together. So I was supposed to get a windshield in it. I'm good. Yeah, I've been kind of dicking with this thing a little bit more. Went for another rip in it. I converted it to the, well, I had a boost leak right here. That guy was leaking. It actually wasn't tight. And then this one was leaking initially when I first took it on its first few rips, you know, the time being. So that kind of felt weird. Didn't feel, you know, responsive. It just kind of felt, and you know, it felt like it had a boost leak, you know. So that's pretty much that. I went ahead and I converted it from the sequential mode to the twin turbo, the true twin turbo mode or whatever. So basically all you do is there's this little controller right here. This thing has basically pressure on it. So this pushes, you know, these little actuators. So if you could see right there, there's like a little thing, and it's not touching the deal. It's pressurized open. So this intake, or this you know, flap that lets boost go by is open, as well as the exhaust that opens up the back of the exhaust valve is completely open. So it definitely spools just a tad later, but it feels really good. So yeah, but it feels like it has a bigger turbo on there, but it's not super laggy, and I like how it's consistent, you know, whereas it's kind of that sequential mode, you know, like I said, it just kind of goes up to like 10, and it like drops down to like 6, and then it like comes up to like 12, whereas right now it's pretty much at 12. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put a manual boost controller on it and turn it up to probably, you know, 15 or so, or whatever it'll let me do, before it gets mad, and I think we'll have a kind of a rip and drift car, so I'm pretty excited about that. But it's nice having the power steering working and the brake booster working, because that was shitty not having that. And then I was doing a donut for the Snapchat, so for all you guys on the Snapchat, enjoyed that. I threw a belt on there, so there's just a lot of distance between that the crank pulley and this pulley up here, and so it just threw it off. And maybe it's because I have that damn aluminum pulley on there. I might just put the factory one back on there. I think it has a little bit bigger ridges on it. You can tell on this, it's pretty flat all the way across. And like on the water pump, it's big. And everywhere else, it's big. So that could be an issue that I see a potential one. So I might do that, burn the shit out of myself doing that. But these fans, I mean, they fucking kick ass. You could watch the temperature go down as they kick on and off. So I got that thermo switch, so it's nice not having to worry about remembering switches. It just turns on when it's hot and turns off when it's cold, so that's kind of dope. Alright, so I messed with some more shit. I got that wire, the wires going back to the taillights and everything wrapped. I pulled off this the shift boot and all that crap. This knob was just an absolute bitch to get on from the factory. They got like a pound of freaking Loctite in there, so I had to wrap this microfiber around and use a damn pipe wrench to get it off. So that was a bitch, but probably gonna leave this big giant thing off and just use this guy, because it looks a hell of a lot cleaner like that. I was thinking about cutting it right there and like moving it forward or something, but I might end up just buying like a Mustang shifter because they're pretty much like that, and then I'll just weld it, just cut that guy off right there, and then just weld it like right on, because this thing has this like big rubber deal around it, which I could probably slice off right there. So I'm not sure yet, but I figure I don't want to move it too crazy forward, because when you do that, then you gain a lot of like throw with it, I feel. So I'm not going to do that. But I got my e-brake mounted. Basically just mounted it to the transmission, the top of it right there, which maybe probably isn't the greatest thing in the world. And I had to kind of cut that thing right there and notch it, and so I could do that. But what I was going to do is, when the e-brake's all the way down, it's really, really close right there. But I was basically going to imagine kind of off of here, like this being a Y and another section going down here. So what I'm going to do is cut a little chunk and go down that way, and then drill a hole and put a nut and a bolt on it, so it'll actually be pretty strong on that side of things. So and then probably bang this out a little bit more, so I have a little bit more room, so I could actually put this boot on, because it's actually pretty nice. So I think that'll be good. That'll clean that area up a lot. And then for this hole right here, it worked out pretty good. I still had this factory deal, stuck that on there and traced it. So I'm gonna cut that all out and make sure I put a paint or a plate, paint it black, and call that good. Yeah, so that's what I'm doing. All right, so I got this little tab welded to that thing and drilled a hole through the tranny. And this right here, this is like essentially a similar spot, because there's like almost three layers of metal there, or two layers, you know, like this thick kind of piece that goes on top, and then the actual tranny tunnel. And it's kind of, you know, braced all the way back there. So that's actually probably the best spot to do that, you know, and then it's just kind of bolted right there on top to kind of, you know, give it some leverage. And technically I could probably just cut this off and it probably wouldn't even need that, but I figure I'll just leave it on there. So I'm going to go ahead and try to do that. I got some paint drying on that. I'm going to go ahead and probably paint this guy, because it's kind of dingy looking. And then I'm probably going to put this thing up in the air and rehook up the e-brake cables, because I actually took them out. So here's kind of a before of, actually this side did it really good earlier. See if you could actually see this. How much the hood pushes down. So I already did the, you know, the expanding foam trick on a few parts of it, but I only had one can. So I'm gonna go ahead and kind of mark a few of the spots that actually need it again, and drill some more holes, and then fill it with foam again, so that I'm gonna cut the hood pins and stuff in it tomorrow. So it should dry enough. So now I'm up underneath the car. You can see there's where that extra e-brake bolt mounts. So that's good. You know, got the 2JZ swap. I'm gonna go ahead and fill, you know, kind of tape up these holes, because a couple people asked me about, you know, what happened to the tranny or whatever. I think I've explained it to you, but I got this out of a wrecked 370Z, so, you know, it basically ripped off like that mount right there on this side. And anyhow, so I gotta yank the drive shaft back out, so that I could stick the e-brake cables back on. So I'm just driving back from a town over with my new buddy right there in the back. That's my windshield for my S14. Kind of what happened was I had a guy who's supposed to come over. Well, it was a glass guy, and he ordered a glass, and it was supposed to be yet here yesterday, and it was the wrong one. So he came over to install it, and then it was the wrong one. So anyhow, I had to call, you know, because they only get deliveries once a week where I live, and then they get deliveries every day, you know, in the town over. So I had to basically drive like an hour to go pick up a windshield, then an hour back, just so I could put it in my damn self tonight. But I'm gonna save a little bit of coin, but I gotta do it my damn self though. But yeah, so that's, you know, one. 2 days before the drift. I don't know. It's Friday night. Sunday. I need to take a nap. So yeah, I'm over here having a fit with how this hood's fitting. You can see how much I spaced up the bottom, and then I actually spaced up the top right there just with that guy. My camera's getting ready to basically run out of film on me. But actually, hold on, I gotta restart this because the thing's in the way. Well, today's Saturday, 10 a.m. Holy shit. Well, what ended up happening is yesterday, Friday, I stayed up pretty much all day on, trying to get some shit done. Had to go pick up a windshield, and, I knew if I took too big of a nap, I wouldn't wake up. Just took like a two-hour nap, and then I was tired as shit last night, so I went to bed at like 1:30, which is weird for me. Especially, the day before a drift event, I usually never get any sleep. Today I woke up at like 8. So maybe I'll actually be on schedule. So I'm going to fire up my damn truck ever since I got the Saab. I haven't drove this thing. Then I'm going to go ahead and get the trailer going. And yeah. So see if this thing will start after it's like week of chilling. How old are you, bud? Holy shit. Some bitch getting old. There we go. Brand new. Alright, so what I'm doing right now, cutting big shitty holes in the piece of shit of hood. You can see right now I got this one getting pretty close to going in. But initially what I did is I put a paint mark on the top of that right there, and then I just kind of drilled a hole, and then I used this that thing, so we got a big ass hole, and then I basically just drilled straight up enough to get these guys sitting through the hood. And once they were sitting up there, I got it and I locked it down, and then I traced a mark all the way around it. So now what I'm doing is just kind of grinding it out. I used the little Dremel guy to cut it, and then now I'm just kind of shaping it, kind of wiggling it around, trying to get it to fit pretty good. This back piece right here is kind of dicking with me a little bit, so I need to probably trim a little bit of that out, but it's coming along. But I need to trim this guy. It's kind of fitting kind of tight in there. And then that top piece on the back, I'm going to trim it down a little bit and then try to get some of that. So that's actually fitting pretty good, other than basically that back chunk right there. So I need to trim a little bit of that out, just right there on that top edge. So I got pretty much everything on. Everything's ready to go, so I'm gonna go for a quick little rip.